Sheridan.
No!
Oh, Sheridan, I'm sorry. It's only me.
Oh, Ivy, I'm sorry.
No, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to wake you up. Are you okay?
I don't know.
Why are you sleeping out here rather than in your bedroom?
I'm not sure. I must have nodded off.
You seemed fine last night.
I was. It was just a bad dream. I'll be all right.
What are your nightmares?
Yes.
I thought you were feeling better about that.
So did I.
Sheridan, Julia explained what happened when you were a little girl. There was no dead body in the house. There was no blood on your hands. It was just all a frightening nightmare.
And I heard what my brother told me. And I believed him. At least I thought I did.
What's made you start doubting him now?
I don't know. It just all seems too real to have been a dream.
So you still think that you might have killed someone? Well, you never did answer me, Sheridan. Do you really believe you killed someone when you were a little girl?
I don't know what to believe anymore, Ivy. I mean, Julian insists that no one ever died, that it was just all in my head, some hysterical fantasy that I conjured up as a child, when he was so convincing. But isn't he always when he wants to get his way?
Yes, well, I certainly felt that way when he was talking last night about Pilar's husband, Martin.
Exactly. The two old and pleasant incidents rear their ugly heads, and all of a sudden, Julian has an answer for both.
Well, that is odd.
I mean, think of it, Ivy. After all these years of Pilar working for our family, none of us, not you, me, or Pilar, ever knew the truth of what happened to Martin.
Or so Julian claims.
And didn't he seem to get a little too uptight last night when we were questioning him about it?
Uptight? He actually forbade us to pursue it any further.
None of this rings true. Mm-hmm. I mean, if Martin had embezzled money from the Crane Industries, Father would have never forgiven him.
That is true. Alistair doesn't forgive the smallest slight. More likely, he would have hung the person from the town square.
Exactly. So why did Julian feel it necessary to come up with such a pathetic story? I mean, what does he care what happened to Pilar's husband?
I don't know. I can still remember the day that Pilar told me that Martin disappeared. She came to work as usual, pretending nothing was wrong. And then I caught her crying in the pantry. Her heart was absolutely breaking.
Poor Pilar.
I asked her what was wrong, and she didn't want to tell me, and I made her tell me. And then she admitted that Martin hadn't come home last night from work. And he always came home on time. He was a very dependable man. A real family man. She was certain something terrible had happened to him.
Why don't I remember any of this?
Well, I think you were already in France. In fact, I think that your father had sent you off that very morning.
Well, that's strange. The two things, one happening right after the other. My having nightmares and being sent off to Paris, and Martin Fitzgerald's disappearance.
Well, it is a coincidence.
And then Julian warning me not to question about either incident. Oh, my God, Ivy.
What are you thinking, Sheridan?
You remember my dream, don't you?
Yes.
I was in the main house in the living room. There was a body under a sheet, and I was standing beside it with my hands covered in blood.
That was only a dream, Sheridan.
What if it wasn't a dream? What if that body is Martin Fitzgerald?
What?
What if I killed Pilar's husband, Luis's father?
Sheridan, that is the most ridiculous thing I've ever heard of. First of all, we don't even know that Martin is dead. Secondly, why would you, a young girl at the time, kill Pilar's husband?
All I know is that the same night I thought I killed someone was the same night that Martin Fitzgerald disappeared.
Okay, it's a coincidence, I'll admit, but it means nothing.
Where's Ethan?
He was back at the house when I left.
I've got to go find him and ask him what he thinks.
Wait for me.
anyone can help me figure this out, it's Ethan.
Yes, I suppose.
Luis told me that someone was using his father's social security number in New Mexico.
Well, then what are you worried about? He's alive. You couldn't have done anything to him.
Well, how do I know that this person is Martin Fitzgerald? What if it's someone just using his ID?
Why would they do that?
I don't know, Ivy. I finally thought that I was free of that night. I really thought that it was just reoccurring bad dreams. But if the body under that sheet is Pilar's husband, oh, of all people.
Good morning, Mother. Sheridan?
Hello, darling. Gwen, it's good to see you here.
It's good to be here. Can we tell them our news, Ethan?
Be my guest.
Don't tell me you're finally going
better to... Better cut to the chase, Gwen. I think Mother's jumped the gun.
Well, Ethan and I are going away for a couple of days.
We are going up to the cabin to spend some quality time together.
We could really use a little downtime to ourselves.
Lately, I've been focusing on everything but Gwen. Mm-hmm. It's time I paid attention to the woman I love.
And he promises to spoil me around the clock, and I intend to hold him to it.
Absolutely.
Why are you leaving? As soon as we pack. Oh, isn't it wonderful, Sheridan?
It's great. I'm so happy for both of you. You both deserve it.
Thank you. How are you doing? How are you feeling?
Me? I'm fine. I couldn't be better.
You have to excuse me. I have a few things to do before I go.
I'll see you later, sweetheart. I better run, too. I still have to pack. I can't tell you how happy it makes me to spend these few days away with Ethan.
Yes, well, maybe my son will finally pop the question this weekend.
Do you really think he's going to propose?
I hope so.
Not half as much as I do.
Well, good luck, Gwen.
Thank you. I'll call you as soon as I get back.
Bye.
Sheridan, I thought you were going to talk to Ethan about your problem.
I couldn't, Ivy. Not after Ethan said he was going to take Gwen away because he'd been neglecting her. And the last thing they need to worry about is me.
Well, heaven knows, I am the first person that want Ethan and Gwen happily married. But I was hoping that you could finally put these dreadful nightmares of yours to rest.
Well, the key is Martin Fitzgerald. Do you really think that Julian is telling the truth about him?
I suppose we could ask him again.
No, I don't want him to think that I'm still suspicious. I just wish I knew if that really was Martin Fitzgerald living in New Mexico as Luis thinks. Oh my goodness, I'm due at the youth center. The last thing I need is for Luis to wonder why I'm late for work. Could the body under the sheet be Luis's father? Could I have killed him? The only way I'm going to find out is if I go to New Mexico, and if Martin Fitzgerald is there, then everything's fine. It'll all be okay. And if he's not, then I'm a killer.
Luis?
He's the last person that can find out what I'm doing. Luis, I need time to attend to a personal matter. Sheridan Crane. Yes, I need the number to the airport. Yes, this is Sheridan Crane. I would like the Crane jet fueled and ready for takeoff right away. And could you please check the weather conditions between here and New Mexico? Oh, thank you. Oh, I'd like to arrive there by this evening. Thank you. Bye-bye. Luis!
So, you're going to New Mexico. This wouldn't have anything to do with my father now, would it?